It's almost summer wedding season, and brides and grooms and their families know it can be a spendy proposition.
But it's not just pricey to be the bride and groom.
No.
It can also add up just going to the wedding. This morning, Kelly Grant has some ways that wedding guests can save money.
If you're the sort of person who cries at weddings, well, these days it might be because of how much money you've spent to be there. The average wedding guest is going to spend $673 this year, according to new data from American Express. And that's just to see the I do's, do a little dancing, have some cake. If you're a member of the bridal party, you're going to spend even more, $701 on average. The bulk of those costs come from travel, so estimate the tally before you RSVP yes to a destination wedding, or really any wedding that requires you to travel far from home. Book the hotel in advance before the couple's discounted hotel block fills up, and use an app like Adioso or Hopper to figure out the best time to buy that airfare. Look on the invitation for details that could add to your out-of-pocket costs, like tuxedo or gown rental if it's a black tie affair, or the cost for a babysitter if the invite is adults only. Also pay attention to extra charges for things like coat check, valet parking, or cocktails at the bar. And then there's the gift. The average spend is $106 for a friend and $142 for a family member. But don't base that on how much the couple is spending to host you. Etiquette experts say your best bet is to look at your own budget and factor in how close you feel to that couple. For CNBC.com, I'm Kelly Grant.
Now, Real Simple offers a few more ideas for guests to save money. Once you receive the invite, it's good to be the first one to go get that gift from the registry if that's what you're doing. That way, you'll have your pick of items in your price range.
That's a smart one. Another idea, gift your services. One bridesmaid created a video for the reception, and it turned into a priceless gift for the newlyweds. You could also respectfully decline your invitation.
Now, if you can't go to a wedding, whether for financial reasons or otherwise, follow up with a phone call and send a simple, small gift to show your appreciation for being invited.